There's nothing like game one in a regional tournament. Tensions are high and there's excitement in the air. On May 16, 2019, the Mules took on the Missouri Southern Lions in game one of the 2019 Central Regional with a chance at the D2 World Series. Mules starting pitcher Ben Kelsch took the mound and tossed an absolute gem. The Mules belted 14 hits with three doubles against three Missouri Southern pitchers, including Zach Parrish, who entered the game with a 9-1 record. Not a bad way to start the tournament. So here's the Mules as they take on the Missouri Southern Lions, a UCM Classic from May 16, 2019.
A degree in digital media production with an emphasis in sports communication will enhance your knowledge in multi-camera live sports productions, in addition to writing for sports media. Our faculty members bring real-world experience to the classroom, and students can showcase their work through different media outlets, including live streaming under the MIAA Network, UCM CTV, and digitalberg.com. For more information on this, please visit ucmo.edu/DMP.
Bob Jackson, Alex Kent back with you from Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field on the UCM campus. We've had the introduction of the teams, the national anthem, a little bit early on us today, so we may start a little bit early, which is fine. The coaches are meeting now with our four-man umpiring crew, and we'll give you the starting lineups as they do that. Lineups today presented by Big O Tires, tire service and repair, brakes, oil, lube, and filters, alignment, and batteries. Big O Tires, your place for all of your auto service needs. Big O Tires, 423 East Young and Warrensburg. Missouri Southern, the visiting team today, they are 35-19. Runner-up to the Mules, of course, during the regular season, 23-10, their conference record. They went 3-2 in the MIAA postseason tournament. Their head coach, Bryce Darnell, in his 12th season, the former Missouri Southern player who had some experience in postseason as a player and also as a head coach. His lineup today, Mike Milligan will lead things off. He'll be in center field. Freddie Landers bats second. He'll play third base. In right field, batting third, Troy Gagan. Matt Miller, the Lions' first baseman, is going to bat fourth today. Ryan Hunter in left field is going to hit fifth. At second base, batting sixth, Dexter Swims. Shortstop, Denver Coffey, bats seventh. The designated hitter will be John Layton. Catching today and batting ninth, Dan Lenz. Pitching for Missouri Southern, left-hander Zach Parrish, the MIAA Pitcher of the Year, 9-1, ERA of 2.23, led the MIAA with 134 strikeouts and only 96 2/3 innings. Bryce Darnell, his 12th season, a record of 359-274, looking for his first win as a head coach for Missouri Southern in postseason, 0-2 in their two previous stints in 2013 and 2015. And now for the Mules and fifth-year head coach Kyle Crooks. The lineup for the Mules, 38-14 overall, winners of the MIAA regular season and the postseason. Mason Janvrin will lead things off. He'll be in center field. Shortstop batting second, Alex Madera. Eric Webb in right field bats third. Harrison Snurbush, third base, hits fourth. And batting fifth at second base, Michael Sinks. In left field batting sixth, Josh Schumacher. Donovan Ditto will be the designated hitter. He'll bat seventh. Zach Whalen behind the plate will bat eighth. And Cole Taylor at first base will bat in the number nine spot. Senior right-hander Ben Kelsch on the mound for the Mules, a 5-3 record, earned run average of 4.15. Kyle Crook's fifth season as head coach for the Mules, a 182-86 overall record, 6-2 in his two previous NCAA regional appearances, 11-7 all-time against Missouri Southern. That's your starting lineup today, presented by Big O Tires, 423 East Young in Warrensburg. Umpiring crew assigned by the NCAA, Bill Powell will be behind the plate. Conan Strobel at first base, Darren Tyson at second base, and Josh Nolan at third base. Our introduction of umpires presented by Warrensburg Chrysler, your five-star authorized dealer on Business 50 in Warrensburg and at warrensburgchrysler.com. Ben Kelsch taking the mound. Mules are on the field getting in their warm-up tosses. And final thoughts, Alex, from you on a key to a win for the Mules today.
You know, I think it's Ben Kelsch's and his ability to locate and command the glove with his two-seam. Make these Southern hitters pound the baseball on the ground and then take care of it defensively. I think if the Mules are able to do that, that's going to give their offense time to get to Parrish. You know, Southern's bullpen is so good, 27-3 when leading after six innings is their record this year. So the Mules need to hang around, keep it close, and then when that offense gets going, take advantage of it.
I tell you, that's key to me. Anytime in postseason, taking advantage of opportunities you get, they're going to be few and far between. And we see it so often, runners left on base will come back to haunt you. So we'll see how both keys to a win come out today as those keys to a victory presented by Key Realty, Warrensburg's real estate expert since 1977, Key Realty of Warrensburg. We are set to go here at Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field. Ben Kelsch ready to go against Mike Million. Senior center fielder for the Lions, a .286 average, 8 home runs, and 33 driven in on the season. Right-handed batter will step in against Ben Kelsch. On a day where the wind now is starting to blow out to left field. So strong wind on a warm day. First pitch from Kelsch is low and outside. Ball one, we are underway. 80 and a third innings for Kelsch, 77 hits, 27 walks, 57 strikeouts this year, a 4.15 ERA for Ben Kelsch. Mike Million, who homered against the Mules in Pittsburgh last week, takes a pitch low and away, and it's 2-0. Million has 8 home runs on the year, 54 hits. He's a guy that transferred from Lincoln a couple of years ago, and boy, Lincoln, who lost their baseball program, their loss was a big gain for Missouri Southern. Ground ball fouled in front of the Mules dugout. Count is 2-1. Zach Whalen catches for the Mules. Snurbush at third. Madera at short. Sinks at second. Taylor at first. The outfield from left to right, Schumacher, Janvrin, and Webb. 2-1 to Mike Million, right-handed batter. Here is the pitch. Fastball inside corner for a called strike. Evens the count at 2-2. Freddie Landers and Troy Gagan will follow on this 87-degree Thursday afternoon in Warrensburg on May 16th. Wind blowing out of the southwest, about 15 miles per hour. 2-2. Here is Kelsch's pitch to Million. Just got a piece of it. Fouled it off the home plate umpire. Zach Whalen turns to make sure that Bill Powell is okay. The count stays 2-2.
You know, that's a big pitch right there. The 2-1, that sinker on the inside corner. If Kelsch is able to locate that ball down and in, and then that's going to open up the outside corner for him to throw his frisbee-type slider away. 2-2 here. See how Whalen wants to attack.
Pitch on the way, throws it low and away, ball three, full count, 3-2. Ben, a 6'2 senior out of St. Louis, Missouri. He has been the Mules' number one starter from day one when he started the season opener in Houston. He's run the count full on Mike Million, and now he checked his swing, and he went around. Strike three as he got that ball up and in on Million, who just could not stop his swing. So one out here at the top of the first inning for Missouri Southern.
And that hole at bat just down, down, down. He elevates the fastball there in Million. These Southern hitters like to elevate that pitch up. Could not hold up on that pitch up out of the zone.
Now Freddie Landers, one of the top hitters in the MIAA this year, 349. 11 home runs on the year for Landers. Pitches high for a ball. Landers, 36 RBIs. He leads the MIAA in being hit by a pitch 22 times this season. Ben Kelsch delivers. Fastball on the outside corner for a called strike. Ben started against the Lions and Zach Parrish back on April 5th in Joplin. Only went 3 1/3 innings, gave up 4 hits, 2 walks, a strikeout, and 2 runs, both earned. Pitch on the way is hit foul off the right side. So Ben Kelsch has the advantage on Freddie Landers, 1 ball and 2 strikes.
And I can see why Landers leads the MIAA in hit by pitches. Big guy, he stands right on top of the plate, takes away that inside corner, and then he's got the protective elbow gear as he leans over that inside corner a little bit.
Yeah, his arms are almost right over the plate. If you can locate an inside fastball, you're in good shape. Instead, pitch outside and low to even the count, 2 balls and 2 strikes.
And that's what most power hitters and Landers with, you know, 11 home runs on the year, these big guys like to get their arms extended. So with Kelsch's ability to throw that sinker, start it middle and run it under his hands, that's a tough pitch for him to get the barrel to.
2-2 on Landers. Ben Kelsch pitch low and away. So second consecutive hitter that Ben has run the count full. He struck out Millia. Now he's 3-2 on Landers. Alex mentioned the Lions like to try to elevate. They led the MIAA in home runs this year with 67. They were sixth overall in hitting, a .277 average.
They don't steal a lot of bases because when they get guys on base, they want to hit that 2-3-run homer.
3 balls, 2 strikes to Landers. Here's the payoff pitch. Hit sharply into center field. That's going to be down for a base hit. So Landers looking fastball away. Got a pitch to hit the other way and singles into center field.
Yeah, and if I'm Kelsch and Whalen, you know, next time he comes up, I want to attack him in more. Don't let him get those arms extended and see that pitch away. So let's see if they can make that adjustment.
Here is Troy Gagin, right fielder for the Lions, a .279 average. 6 home runs, 37 driven in. Keep an eye on Landers. He has 7 stolen bases in as many attempts. The Lions, 55 steals as a team this season. Hear that wind just blowing right into our crowd mic. Fastball just a bit outside. 1 ball and no strikes. These umpires, of course, not all from the MIAA. We have some from the Northern Sun Conference as well. So they are the regional umpires. 1-0 pitch on the way. Hit foul off the right side by Gagin. Count 1 ball and 1 strike.
You know, that's probably the biggest adjustment that the players have to make is, because you get used to your conference umpires in their strike zones, and we've seen the MIAA umpires have a pretty big in or outside corner, but not so much inside corner. But so far today, been pretty tight on that outside corner.
1 ball, 1 strike to Gagin. Landers the lead at first with 1 away here in the top of the first. Pitch up and in. It's 2-1. The Mules against Missouri Southern in the regular season won 2 out of 3 with those last 2 games. Wild affairs. The Mules led 9-0 in the second game and lost, then trailed 13-1, trailed by 7 going to the 9th inning and won. So you never know when these two teams get together. Both games in the MIAA tournament with 5-4 finals. 2-1 pitch to Gagin. There's a good inside fastball to the inside corner. And the count, 2 balls and 2 strikes to Gagin.
And that's that pitch. You know, I know Kelsch has gotten a couple balls on pitches he wants on the outside corner, but that's the pitch. If the umpire's going to give that to you, keep pouring it in there, because these hitters, they stand on top of the dish. They don't want that ball in.
2-2 to Gagin. Landers with the lead, and the pitch is high. So Ben, for the third consecutive hitter, is going to run the count full, 3-2, with Matt Miller, big left-handed slugger on deck. So we'll see about Freddie Landers. Does he run 3-2 here with one out? What about the pitch selection? Payoff pitch coming instead to first base, and it got back. Boy, they had Landers dead to right at first base, but somehow got back to first base on that pickoff attempt.
Yeah, better throw there, and he's absolutely out. Just throw just a touch high, and Taylor trying to get the tag down to him. First base umpire says he got his hand in.
So Landers now with the lead at first base. And again, they'll throw over. But again, that time, Landers wasn't headed to second base. So three balls and two strikes to Troy Gagan. Landers the walking lead at first there with one out. Here is Kelsch's pitch, and he struck him out on the inside corner. Gagan asking the home plate umpire, did I swing or was it a called strike? And I think either way, Alex, it was a pretty good pitch.
Yeah, is that fastball in, and as a sinker baller, especially when the wind is blowing like it is from that first base dugout, third base dugout, you throw that pitch middle and almost let it ride that wind in underneath the hands. And so out of the hand, the hitter's like, oh my gosh, that's a meatball I want to hit. And by the time they gets there, it's too late for them to stop their swing.
Now Matt Miller, dangerous left-handed batter, takes a pitch high and away for a ball. Miller moved up to the number four spot today as he had homered against the Mules in the MIAA tournament twice. 11 home runs to tie Landers for the team lead. Hitting 253. Ben Kelsch's pitch, tried to keep it away from him, outside 2-0. Ben made a start in the MIAA tournament, the opener a week ago against Missouri Western, went 6 1/3, gave up 7 hits, didn't walk anybody, had 2 strikeouts. 4 runs, 2 earned. The Mules, of course, winning that game 5-4. Ben was not the pitcher of record. So a dangerous 2-0 pitch coming to Miller here, and he hits it foul off the left side. Now 2-1. Landers at first with 2 outs here at the top of the first inning as we are just underway from Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field. NCAA Division II Central Sub-Regional game number 1. St. Cloud State and Central Oklahoma will follow at 7 o'clock tonight. 2-1 pitch to Miller. Got jammed with the pitch inside and dials it back to the screen. Count even now 2-2. Miller leads this team in strikeouts. I take that back. He's one behind Denver Coffee, 52. Coffee has 53. The Lions do strike out. Again, they're a team that likes to hit them out of the park if they can and hit extra bases. 2-2 pitch to Miller, and again, way high. So fourth straight hitter that Ben Kelsch is going to be 3-2, which obviously means he's thrown a lot of pitches here in this first inning.
Yeah, a lot of pitches, and I think this is where the benefit of the not having an 8-team regional. Kelsch, this is the one game he's throwing this weekend, so you can let him go deep, and then if you win, you can deal with him next weekend.
Three balls, two strikes, payoff pitch, change, and a swing and a miss. So Ben ran it as long as he could on every hitter he saw in the first inning. Gives up a single but gets 3 strikeouts. And the Mules get away in the top of the first with the Lions not scoring. Nothing doing at the top of inning number 1. And now the Mules take on the challenge of the MIAA Pitcher of the Year, left-hander Zach Parrish, when they come to bat in the bottom of the first, no score.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub. With exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship found nowhere else, make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
Mules come to bat, bottom of the first, no score. Mason Jandrin will lead it off against left-hander Zach Parrish. 6'1", 165, junior from Tahlequah, Oklahoma. He transferred from Northeastern State a couple of seasons ago. Jandrin, 4'10 average. First pitch, slow breaking ball in there for a called strike. Zach Parrish, 9-1, making his 16th start. ERA of 2.23. Pitch to Jandrin is a fastball inside. One ball, one strike. 96 and two-thirds innings, only 62 hits allowed, only 32 walks, 134 strikeouts. Jandrin rolls this one right back up the middle. Slow roller, picked up by Swims. Throw to first, not in time. So Mason Jandrin right off the bat extends his on-base streak to 53 straight games this year and 65 dating back to last year on that infield single.
Number 7, Alex Madera.
And it just soft enough.
And that's what speed can do to you. You know, this Parrish guy, we didn't see it there. That ball was kind of cued off the end. But I think talking with Coach Crooks yesterday, the thing that's most impressive about him is he's so calm, cool, and collected, very athletic. He fields his position really well.
So Alex Madera at the play. We'll keep an eye on Mason, of course, but Parrish, a very good guy with the pickoff move to first. And right off the bat, we see a throw to first. So lefties normally are pretty decent at that, but you saw Zach Parrish in the past. You know, when he pitched for Northeastern State, we saw him, and he had a good pickoff move. Here's the pitch to Madera. Hits this ball into center field, and that ball is going to be over the head of the center fielder, Million. That will score Mason Janvern. Alex Madera thought about going on to third, could have made it, but instead will stop at second with a double to drive in Mason Janvern.
You know, and one thing we've talked about, these teams know each other. This is a really good start of a rivalry between these two programs. Madera gets a fastball up and doesn't try to do too much, and I think the wind helped carry that away from the center fielder, Million, and, you know, Mules off to a good start. Infield single, and then your double, and now you got the MIAA Player of the Year and Eric Webb at the dish.
So quite a matchup here. Pitcher of the Year, Player of the Year. Alex Madera drives in his 34th run of the year. Eric Webb, 414, 18 home runs, 70 driven in. Zach Parrish's pitch to Webb is a high fastball. Webb got his 18th home run in the MIAA tournament last weekend in Pittsburgh, Kansas. Just felt like yesterday got back from Pittsburgh. Here we are playing baseball again after five games there last week. Madera with the lead at second base. Parrish's pitch is in there for a called strike. Now, here's the situation, Alex, we talked about with guys in scoring position. Nobody out. You've got one run in. You want to get greedy and get that other guy in from second.
Absolutely. Take advantage, especially early on. You see it a lot. When the ace is on the mound, get to him early before he settles into his rhythm. With the second baseman holding Madera here, that right side of the infield is wide open.
One ball, one strike to Webb. Madera with the lead at second. Here's the pitch. Now he squares to bunt, pops it up, and that's going to be off the tip of the glove by Parrish. And we saw his athleticism there coming off the mound and running into foul territory and nearly caught that ball.
Yeah, just couldn't complete the play, but right there you see the effort, the very low effort athleticism that he has. And, you know, Webb gets away with that one right there. He was trying to push that ball past the pitcher without the second baseman there. That's a base hit waiting to happen if you can execute. Just got underneath it.
So now Webb down to the count. One ball and two strikes to Parrish. Gets the sign from his catcher, Dan Lenz. Parrish checks the runner at second base and delivers. Webb rolls this one toward third. And they tried to tag, didn't get the runner. Webb is out, but still Madera on running contact, able to get under the tag and by the tag of Landers to get to third. So there he is with only one out for Harrison Snurbush.
Yeah, and that's a really good job of base running by Madera. If you hesitate at all there, it's a tag in and out. But he read the slow roller, saw down angle, and took off. And now Missouri Southern early in this ballgame, talking about postseason and not a whole lot of runs out there. Infield comes in with one out here in the first.
Snurbush, 297 average. Here's the pitch. Big old slow breaking ball catches the outside corner for a strike. Snurbush, 7 home runs, 41 driven in, 57 hits on the season. Infield in for Missouri Southern here in the bottom of the first inning. 0-1 pitch, a swing and a miss. Snurbush on a change, so he is down 0-2. And Parrish knows he needs a strikeout here or a ground ball at one of his infielders.
And that shows you the confidence. Throws a big breaking ball for a strike and then comes back with that plus changeup and had Snurbush way out in front.
Nothing and two on Harrison. Parrish's pitch elevated in the air towards shallow right. Gagan coming in, still coming in. Madera at third is down the line, but he will not attempt to score as Gagan's throw right on the money. So Snurbush got the bat on the ball but didn't elevate it deep enough. Flies out to shallow right, so now the Mules need a two-out hit from Michael Sings to get that runner home from third.
And that's where that wind blowing in hurts you. I think that ball still would have been too shallow, but with the wind just pushing it in towards the infield, there's no way you can challenge that arm of Gagan.
So Michael Sinks now, right-handed batter, runner at third base. Sinks gets tied up with the fastball and fouls it back. Michael, 304, 8 home runs, 51 driven in, 7 of 18 at the MIAA tournament with one triple. Sinks has had good success against the Lions this season. Parrish is 0-1 pitch on the way. Saints taps it foul. So Parrish again jumps in front. No balls and two strikes.
You know, I think the adjustment that Parrish has made after that Madeira double is he's gone a lot to breaking ball changeups early in the count, kind of pitching backwards. And we saw him 0-2 fastball to Schnurbusch that got the pop out. 0-2 here. See if they follow that same script.
0-2 pitch on the way. Tried to hit the outside corner with a high fastball and missed. Count one ball and two strikes.
So it looks like with two teams that are pretty familiar with each other, that's the quick adjustment that Missouri Southern has made is, hey, we're going to pitch backwards to these aggressive hitters of the Mules.
Madeira down the line at third. Here comes the 1-2 pitch to Sinks. A little nubber off the first base side is going to be foul, and first base coach Alex Backus will field. Alex coaches at first. Kyle Crooks, of course, in his normal third base coaching box, head coach for the Mules. In his ninth NCAA regional game, he is 6-2 in the previous two trips. One ball, two strikes to Michael Sinks, and he struck him out. So Parrish able to come back strong after giving up the leadoff infield single and the double to Madeira. Webb grounds out, Schnurbusch flies to shallow right, and then Sinks down on strikes. One run, two hits, no errors, one left for the Mules. We head to the top of the second. Mules lead Missouri Southern 1-0.
A degree in digital media production with an emphasis in digital journalism will develop your skill set for work in multimedia outlets, including online and broadcast. Our faculty members bring real-world experience to the classroom, and students can showcase their work online at digitalberg.com and in the student-led newspaper, The Mule Skinner. For more information on this or other concentrations within the digital media production program, please visit ucmo.edu/DMP.
87 degrees at first pitch at about 3:24 this afternoon. Game time at 10 presented by Warrensburg Ford, where you get the best vehicles at the best price. East Business 50 in Warrensburg or online at warrensburgford.com. Ryan Hunter will lead things off for Missouri Southern, left-handed batter. First pitch from Ben Kelsch, swung on and missed by Hunter. 269 average, 7 home runs, 23 driven in. Ben Kelsch, 0-1 pitch on the way, high and away for a ball. Count even, one ball and one strike. Ben Kelsch, 25 pitches in that first inning. Hunter takes a fastball outside corner. Well thrown. Hunter didn't agree. It's one ball and two strikes. Ryan Hunter hit in the number 9 spot of the two games the Mules played the Lions in Pittsburgh last weekend. Left-handed batter. 1-2 pitch on the way. Did he go around? Checked his swing. Did he swing? No. He held up. Count two balls and two strikes. Hunter has been a platoon player for the most part. He's kind of stepped into that left field role, though, recently. Kelsch is hammered into deep right field. That ball is going to be down and over the head of Eric Webb up against the wall. Hunter on his way to second base, and he'll be there with the leadoff double. So he got a pitch in on him, but he was able to get the bat through the zone and double into right field for a leadoff hit for the Lions here in this second inning.
Yeah, and just one of those sinkers that, from Kelsch that got elevated and center cut. And does a good job, Hunter does, of getting the barrel to the ball, even after not getting that borderline call a couple pitches before. He stayed locked in and put a good swing on it, and now Missouri Southern with the leadoff double.
Here is Dexter Swims, the MIAA Freshman of the Year. 327, 5 home runs, 35 driven in. So we'll see about what the Lions do. Will they try to move that runner to third with a bunt or have Dexter Swims up there to hit away? Schnurbusch, the third baseman for the Mules, even with a bag. Cole Taylor coming in at first base. Not showing a bunt. Sweeping breaking ball smothered by Zach Whalen. Count one ball, no strikes. Top of the second, Lions have a runner at second with nobody out. Mules an early 1-0 lead. Each team two hits. Kelsch gives a peek back to Hunter, the runner at second. Delivers to Swims, hits sharply to second. Sinks in perfect position, makes the play to first. That gets Hunter to third. Thank goodness Sinks was playing up the middle. Otherwise, that's going to be a base hit.
Yeah, that ball, you know, elevated once again. And Swims, the freshman, does a great job of staying middle of the field there. A lot of times you would see hitters roll that over and the runner at second not able to move, but he hits behind the runner and a productive out there for the Lions.
Now Denver Coffey, the shortstop, 277, six home runs, 38 driven in. He leads this team in strikeouts. Ben Kelsch, who had three in the first inning, would like one right now. Kelsch has pitched to Denver Coffey as a high fastball, so Ben's getting everything kind of up. 25 first-inning pitches on an 87-degree hot, humid day can start to take its toll on you. One ball, no strikes to Denver Coffey. Here's Kelsch's pitch. Check swing. Whalen able to stop that breaking ball. And now the count, two balls and no strikes.
So it looks like, you know, early on here, he's just overthrown a little bit. And sometimes punching three guys out in the first inning, you're like, oh, I got my good stuff. I can go rack up the strikeouts. And then you go back out and you're just off with your command as he's fall behind 2-0.
2-0 pitch to Coffey, high and away, ball three. So Coffey not taking a swing at any pitch out of the strike zone.
And really, a walk here isn't the worst thing in the world with his ability to get ground balls and the Mules' ability defensively to roll up a lot of double plays this year. So a walk here isn't the worst thing in the world. You get to start over fresh.
Three balls, no strikes. Taking 3-0, it's on the outside corner for a strike. Now 3-1 to Denver Coffey. 57 hits this year for Coffey. Leads the team with 20 doubles. Hunter down the line at third with one down. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Might have got a piece of it. Now it's a full count, 3-2.
And that's the good fastball located down that just misses the barrel, sinks underneath it. So from 3-0 back to now 3-2 after two well-thrown fastballs.
So we'll see what Ben Kelsch and the Mules elect to throw. Payoff pitch coming to Denver Coffey. Here it is, and he foul tipped it right off of Whalen's mask all the way back to the screen. So we'll do 3-2 all over again here with one away in the top of the second.
Once again, you want to get your out here, but that pitch is a little bit too good of a 3-2 pitch, in my opinion. You know, you can be okay here. Still a
plate umpire, Bill Powell, had nothing to do with that. So it's 1-0 on John Layton, right-handed batter. Pitch on the way. Slow breaking ball, let her high for a strike.
Yeah, still early on in the game here. The pitcher catcher is still trying to figure out, hey, what is this umpire going to give us? How far is he going to give us off that outside corner? So that first pitch, Whalen trying to get it, but good comeback breaking ball right there to even the count.
Runner down the line at third. 1-1 pitch is a high fastball. Count 2-1. Layton 6-3, so that high breaking ball a moment ago to another hitter might not have been a strike. Ben off the mound for a moment, now climbs the hill, peers in for the sign from Zach Whalen. Two balls, one strike, here is the pitch. Swing and a miss at a high fastball. So Ben now one strike away from getting out of the inning and keeping the tying run at third. The Lions one hit away from getting that tying run home. 2-2 to Layton, Ben Kelsch to the plate. Strike three called outside corner. Well, Ben's thrown a lot of pitches early in this ball game, but he has saved a couple of dandy called third strike pitches on the outside corner here in the second. And like the Mules, the Lions leave a runner at third with less than 2 outs. So nothing for Missouri Southern in the second. We head to the bottom of inning number two. Mules lead Missouri Southern 1-0. 7-8 for the Mules here in the bottom of the second inning. Josh Schumacher will lead things off against left-hander Zach Parrish. Lefty-lefty matchup here. First pitch is inside corner for a called strike. Parrish pitched 7 innings against the Mules back on April the 5th. Gave up 4 hits, 2 runs, 1 earned, a walk, and 3 strikeouts. Pitch to Schumacher is tapped to first. Miller is going to grab it. He will go to the bag himself. Far out number 1. So Josh Schumacher, batting 394, is out on a ground ball unassisted to first. That'll bring up the DH, Donovan Ditto. 326, one home run, 24. So now Parrish has the advantage, ball and 2 strikes. Donovan Ditto, right-handed batter. Tap foul to the plate as Parrish took something off that pitch. Count stays 1 ball and 2 strikes. Outfield playing straight away against Donovan. 42 hits on the season for Ditto. 6 doubles, a couple of triples, and 1 home run. Way inside it, hit him. And Donovan now has been plunked 12 times this year as Parrish tried to come inside and got away from him.
You know, and that's why so many hitters, especially when you get to 2 strikes, you get up on top of the plate. One, to take away that outside corner, but also that inside corner starts to disappear a little bit. Your margin for error disappears, and great way to get on base for your team.
Now Zach Whalen, 343, 4 home runs, 35 driven in. Parrish to the plate, pitches high and away for a ball. Zach Whalen, 5 for 16 in the MIAA tournament in Pittsburgh, Kansas. Had a couple of doubles, including that double that tied the game against the Lions in the 9th inning. Change up way outside for a ball. Whalen's double in that 9th inning after the Mules had fallen behind 4-3 in the elimination game. Play to Zach Elam, the pinch runner from first, and then Mules ended up winning the ball game. Throw to first, back is Ditto. Dalton Dull then ran for Zach Whalen and scored on the base hit by Mason Janvrin. Whalen with the advantage, 2 balls, no strikes. Zach Parrish from the stretch, pitches. Way outside, ball 3. So Zach not offering it anything. Looks down to head coach Kyle Crooks to see if anything might be on 3-0 or if it's a take sign. And Donovan Ditto will know the same. 3-0 pitch to Whalen. Taking 3-0, it's right in there for a strike, 3-1. This is a good hitter's count and a good count to run on. Hit and run if you want to try it, but Ken Parrish has a good move. So if you're going to run, you have. Cole was just 2 for 19 in the MIAA tournament. Third baseman Freddie Landers playing even with the back just in case Taylor tries to bunt here. Not showing a bunt. Breaking ball stays inside.
And I wouldn't be surprised if Coach Crooks gives Cole Taylor a strike here and then comes back and says, hey, let's go ahead and try to take advantage of this 2 runners on and 1 out and get him into scoring position with 2 outs.
Shortstop Coffee playing near the runner, so a lot of room on the left side of the infield for Taylor. And there it is, ground ball. Oh, the diving stop by the third baseman. Throw to first, not going to be in time to get the double play, but Freddie Landers saved a run. As Cole Taylor did exactly what we talked about, Alex, he tried to hit it to the left side. Unfortunately, just hit it close enough that Landers can make a headlong dive to grab that ground ball and get the force play at second.
And that was a good job, a good athletic play by Landers for the big guy. We talk about his offensive prowess at the plate, but headlong dive, understands that you're probably not going to get 2 there once you leave your feet, but make sure the first one. And now first and third, 2 outs for the Mules.
So here is Mason Janvrin. Had the infield singled and scored in the double by Alex Madera. Hit number 94 for Janvrin this year. Pitch on the way, a swing and a miss as Parrish pulled the string. Mason had 9 hits in the MIAA tournament, went 9 for 24. 2 runs scored, 4 driven in.
And there's that confidence in that changeup. 0-0, first and third, 2 outs, and a changeup.
0-1 pitch, tailing fastball away. And a count, 1 ball and 1 strike. I think Zach Parrish has about 4 different speeds on his fastball, a couple on his change. It's why he is what he is, a good pitcher. Can locate all of his pitches.
Yeah.
Time is called as Lenz wants to make sure the infield knows what they're going to do here for Missouri Southern.
Yeah, and you're exactly right. You know, having the ability to throw three-plus pitches for strikes, but then also turn those pitches into six when you can add and subtract.
1-1, breaking ball swinging and a miss by Mason. Now he is down to the count, one ball and two strikes.
You know, he's away, 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 and then he throws you a back foot breaking ball that Mason swings over the top of. You know, this Coach Crooks, me and him visited for a short time yesterday. This guy's tough. He's a handful.
1-2 pitch. Mason ground ball fair inside the line of third. One run will score. Cole Taylor rounding third. They're going to send him home. Here's the throw to the plate. Cole is safe on the two-run double by Mason Janvren.
So Parrish throws that back foot breaking ball and gets an ugly swing and a miss by Janvren, but he comes back with it 1-2, leaves it middle, and Janvren, great hand-eye coordination, able to keep that ball fair down the line. And the Mules extend their lead to 3-0. That's a big two-out.
Got even, one ball and one strike. Janvren with the lead at second. Madera, right-handed batter, 1-1 pitch. Low and inside, Mason way off of second base. Has to dash back in as Dexter Swims cut in behind him. Mason's not afraid to try to steal third. 34 steals to lead the MIAA this season. Two balls and one strike to Madera. Zach Parrish's pitch way outside. 3-1 with Eric Webb on deck.
You know, I think early on here, the Mules offense has done a really good job of not being too over-aggressive. They've had a few swings where they've tried to go get that changeup breaking ball, but really they're letting Parrish come to them.
3-1 pitch. Madera pops it up. He jammed him. Made a good pitch. The shortstop, Coffey, in shallow left center field, makes the catch. And the inning is over. But the Mules take advantage of a hit batter and a walk. On the two-run double by Mason Janvren. Janvren, Mules leave one. They've stranded two in the first two innings. We head to the top of the third. Game one of this Division II Central Sub-Regional. Mules lead Missouri Southern 3-0.
A degree in digital media production with an emphasis in audio will enhance your skill set for work in radio, television, film, and beyond. Our faculty members bring real-world experience to the classroom, and students can showcase their work on UCM Radio The Beat, as well as in film projects and live events. For more information on this or other concentrations within the Digital Media Production Program, please visit ucmo.edu/DMP.
Goes on top 3-0 as Missouri Southern comes to bat here in the top of inning number three. Bob Jackson, Alex Kent with you in the broadcast booth at lovely Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field. Connor Cummings, our studio engineer. Dan Lenz, right-handed batter, swings at the first pitch and fouls it back. Ben Kelsch now 44 pitches in the first two innings. It'll be Lenz, the number nine hitter, then Mike Million and Freddie Landers. A one pitch on the way, a little slow breaking ball, a high hopper to short. Madera's throw to first on the money, one down. Five strikeouts in the first two innings for Ben Kelsch. So one away for the leadoff hitter, Mike Million. Started this game by striking out. Kelsch struck out three in the first, two in the second. Worked around a leadoff double in that second inning. Pitch on the way, a high breaking ball. One ball, no strikes.
You know, I think early on here, Kelsch hasn't had his A-plus stuff. He's fighting the command a little bit, but he's competing his tail off, and that's what Coach Crooks wants.
Pitch to Million, inside corner. The bottom of the third for the Mules. Eric grounded out to third, his first at bat. He hits it hard to third again. Off the hands of Landers, a no play as the ball ricocheted to Coffey at shortstop. Webb hit that ball a ton toward third, and it ate up Freddie Landers.
Third baseman at number
eight. So the Mules get their leadoff man on. And I have not seen them score that yet, but I would think that has to be a hit. Alex, you?
I would agree. I think that ball is absolutely torched. One hop, short hop to the third baseman.
It is an infield single. First pitch to Snurbush is low for a ball. So Webb is at first base with nobody out. Snurbush flies to shallow right field back in the first inning. One ball, no strikes. Here's the pitch. Little fly ball center field. That's down in front of Milligan for a base hit. So the Mules, back-to-back singles from Webb and Snurbush to start the third inning. And Alex, I'll go back to what you were talking about. Mules really aren't trying to slug the ball. They're just making small contact, trying to just get the bat through the zone and meet the ball.
Yeah, and I think the flip side of this, what it does to the Missouri Southern hitters, we saw last inning, they're starting to get a little antsy in the batter's box. They're trying to maybe take bigger swings and swing the momentum back, and Kelsch is now commanding pitches. And so I think it's getting close to that when you're on the Lions side and your best pitcher, the conference pitcher of the year, has given up three runs in the first two innings. Your hitters are going to try to do a little bit more than they need to. And so, let's see. Once again, first and second, nobody out. See if the Mules can take advantage and continue to tack on runs here early in this ballgame.
Michael Sinks, the hitter, struck out in the first. Infield for the Lions looking for a bunt. He is squaring to bunt, takes the ball back, and now the runner at second. Webb started to go to third and had to hustle back as Lenz got to that ball. And if Webb had tried to go to third, it would not have been a good result.
Man, that's a good job. The rule is if you hesitate, shut it down and live to play another day.
I guess he offered at the pitch. Nope, they changed it. One ball and no strikes. I didn't think he bunted at it. One ball and no strikes. Infield still looking. Sinks again, showing bunt, gets it down. Parrish off the mound, throws to third. They'll get the force out. Not a good bunt. He'll struggle with their bunting last weekend in Pittsburgh, and once again, that bunt was a one-hopper just to the third base side of Zach Parrish. All he had to do was come off, grab it, and momentum already taking him to his third baseman to throw out Webb.
You know, we talked earlier about his ability to field his position, and that was one thing Coach Crooks was very aware of yesterday, and we have to do a good job of pressuring fair or foul with no strikes on bunt situations. Sinks there, caught too much of fair territory there, and easy put out 1-5.
Now Josh Schumacher, runners at first and second. Slow breaking ball to Schumacher inside for a ball. Josh rolled out to first base to start the second inning. Josh has obviously hit the ball very well since he took over in left field. He was 4-for-16 in the MIAA tournament with a couple of doubles. Lefty-lefty matchup here with one out in the bottom of the third. First and second, Mules. Parrish a peek back to the runners, and as a base hit into left field, he just went that way. Here comes Snurbush rounding third. He's going to score, and Schumacher did what Cole Taylor tried to do, Alex, the last inning. That time it was in that vacated hole for an RBI single.
Yeah, a breaking ball just middle of the plate, and you see a lot of young hitters try to really hook that ball and probably hit into a double play, but Schumacher, he's shown such a great ability to control the barrel. Just takes his single, and Schnurbush scores easily to extend the lead.
So the Mules now a half a dozen hits and lead 4-0. Here in the bottom of the third for Donovan Ditto, who reached by being hit by a pitch on a 2-2 count back in the second. He would come around to score way out in front of a change. Now a throw down to second. They've got the runner picked off, and the throw is out. Sinks just got caught, and now Sinks is hurt.
Yeah, it looks like sliding into third base head first, maybe dislocated a finger, and hopefully it's something that doesn't affect his ability to continue on in this game or this weekend, but just kind of caught in no man's land. I think he was trying to see and anticipate ball in dirt, and a good job from the catcher Lenz to backpick him there.
So now one out, runner at first base, two outs I should say, only one runner on, and Ditto a swing and a miss at a change away. He is down to the count 0-2. Ditto, of course, is the DH. If Sinks could not continue, they'd probably put Dalton Dole at second. But he slid head first into the bag, and that hurt his thumb. Pitch high and away. Now another throw to first, and Miller saves that from going down the right field line. Mules are, as always, aggressive on their leads, but, you know, you got to be careful, too, not to overextend those leads at time, and that cost the Mules.
Yeah, you don't want to run yourself out of potential big innings here, and we know Lenz, he likes to throw the ball around, so Mules need to make that adjustment.
One ball, two strikes. The pitch to Ditto. Tried a backdoor breaking ball and missed away. And I think, evens the count 2-2.
Sorry, Bob. And that can be a little bit of frustration, I think, on the Mules when you have a pitcher on the mound that's got a good move. You want to try to take ball and dirts and secondary leads and that kind of stuff, and then you can get backpicked.
2-2 to Ditto. Swing and a miss. Another big change, and Donovan down on strikes. So the Mules do score another run. Had a chance for more with 2-1 and 1 out. But have one guy thrown out of the base paths and leave one. They've stranded runners in each of the first three innings. But the Mules have also scored in each of the first three. We head to the top of the fourth. Mules now lead 4-0.
We can stop to make sure someone is okay.
Get in the way and disrupt the situation.
Codify an authority.
Or walk them home safely.
We can change the language around rape.
We can make campuses safer for our teammates, our friends, and our classmates.
We cannot be bystanders.
Taking action isn't always easy, but it's on us
to intervene.
Because we can.
Learn more and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Ben Kelsch only threw 8 pitches in that third inning, so his pitch count at 52 going into the fourth, facing 3, 4, and 5 for Missouri Southern. Troy Gagan, one of the 3 strikeout victims in the first, 1 of 5 in the ballgame, will lead things off for Missouri Southern. Mules lead 4-0 here at the top of the fourth inning. Ben Kelsch kicks and delivers. Big slow breaking ball stays outside. 1-0 and 0 strikes. Mules wearing the white uniforms today, the Lions gray. Pitch in there for a called strike. With the green, of course, the Missouri Southern green. Gagan, Miller, and Hunter. A couple of left-handed batters to follow. Tap foul as they got that ball in on Troy Gagan. Now he is down to the count, 1-2 strikes.
And now you can kind of see the chess match begin to form. Missouri Southern's got a righty throwing in the bullpen, so I'm wondering if they're looking at this saying, hey, we might take Lentz out or our starter Parrish.
Swing and a miss on the inside fastball. Well thrown, well located again, Alex.
Yeah, absolutely. No, they might. You might see, hey, maybe we can take Parrish out, because if we lose this ball game, we're going to have to come back and play extra ball games and save Parrish for a Saturday game. If it gets to it, something like that. So early on here, but you can see Bryce Darnell might be thinking that line.
Now Matt Miller, left-handed batter. First pitch to Miller's foul to our left. Miller, a strikeout victim in the first as well. Well, the sub-regionals now just 4 teams. You've got to win 3 games at least to win the sub-regional, 4 if you lose a game. The 0-1 pitch. Good breaking ball inside corner, but that's the difference in a longer regional. You may only go one pitcher, one starting pitcher. Sometimes you can go another guy who starts your first game if you get into the championship. 0-2 pitch. Hit to left field down the line and well hit it. That's fair. It's gone. It is. A home run, Miller the other way. He did that to the Mules in Pittsburgh. He just went with a pitch away and had a short swing, and the wind kept it fair, and the Lions are on the board. It's now 4-1.
Yeah, and that's, we talked about it in the first inning, those big hitters that like to hit for power, they want to get their arms extended. When you go and tie them up, that's when they're uncomfortable, and fastball middle away, and you just kind of almost Miller flicks his wrist, and it's 340-some feet out of the ballpark down left field line.
So 4-1 now, Mules. Here is Ryan Hunter, who doubled in the second. First pitch from Ben is on the outside corner for a called strike. So Matt Miller now 3 home runs in the last 3 games against the Mules. He now leads the Lions with a dozen this year. Nothing and one on Hunter, left-handed batter. Kels tried to needle that outside corner again, and it was off the plate. Count even at 1-1 strike. Fortunately, the Mules gave up some home runs to the Lions in Pittsburgh, breaking ball way outside, but they were all solo shots, and that's the important thing about home runs. If you can keep them in the solo shot, Stafford hit 4 solo shots in the game.
Yep. Typically, solo home runs don't beat you. It's the walk home run that can give you a lot of pain.
2-1 pitch to Hunter. Good fastball there. He tied him up with an inside fastball to the corner. And the count now 2-2.
Especially with these lefties, with the wind kind of blowing how it is, it's going to help balls into that left center gap get blown to the short porch. You've got to keep them honest and come in every once in a while.
2-2 pitch on the way. Strike three call. Letter high strike. Inside corner. Ben's not afraid today, Alex, to keep that ball inside.
Yeah, and that's how you have to be successful today, especially against this team. You know, we keep talking about it. Teams that want to hit home runs, those guys want to get their arms extended. They want to get the barrel to the baseball. And so Kelsch can locate that fastball on both sides of the plate. Should mean good things for the Mules.
Here is Dexter Swims, who grounded out to his counterpart at second, Michael Sinks. Fastball outside corner. By the way, Sinks is out there again at second base. So whatever happened to his hand, they repaired it, either a thumb that might have gotten jammed. 0-1 pitch to Swims. Ground ball to short. Madera deep in the hole. Has to throw across his body and not in time. He just didn't have enough time to get a lot of strength on that throw. And Swims got down the line in a hurry. So that'll be an infield single for Dexter Swims.
I think that second hop kind of surprised Madera a little bit. He started charging in hard and then at the very last minute kind of had to reach back into his arm side to kind of get off balance. So I think he was expecting that ball to be a little bit slower hit than it was.
Now Denver Coffey, strikeout victim in the second. So a runner at first base with two outs for the Lions. Mules lead 4-1 here in the top of the fourth. Pitch low and outside for a ball. One ball and no strikes. Well, I tell you this, neither one of these teams have played in this warm of a condition this year. 87 at first pitch. Humid. More like a summer-type day. So both these teams are going to have to fight through that. One ball, no strikes. Here's the pitch. Coffey rolls this one into left field. Base hit. So back-to-back singles from Swims and Coffey. And the Lions now have a handful of hits.
You know, we talked about in postseason play, it getting to two outs is just the half of it. You got to finish your inning. Those two out hits, errors, walks, guys that get on base can almost rejuvenize the dugout. And Missouri Southern here has got it set up with two outs here in the inning.
John Layton struck out back in the second. Layton, a right-handed batter, batting just under 300, so a dangerous hitter. Ben Kelsch trying to wait through him to get out of this fourth inning, still with a three-run lead. High fastball to Layton, one ball and no strikes. A one-out home run by Matt Miller. Gave the Lions a run, but the Lions now with two outs have back-to-back singles and have the tying run at the plate. Ben Kelsch looking in for the sign from Zach Whalen. One ball, no strikes. Here's the pitch. Good breaking ball inside corner. And the count, one ball and one strike.
You know, on this hot, warm day, sun's high in the sky, it's important for Ben Kelsch to really control his breathing here, and he's doing that right now, taking a good deep breath in and out, and then locking in on his catcher, Zach Whalen, for the sign.
One ball, one strike. A look back to the runner at second. Both runners lead away. Layton takes a fastball outside corner. Now it's one ball and two strikes. So let's see what Ben and the Mules have elected to throw here, one and two.
They went fastball for a backwards K in his last at-bat. Let's see. 1-2, I like fastball away here.
One ball, two strikes. Here is the pitch. He did throw a fastball away, and Layton fought it off. Fouled it straight back to the screen.
Now you can build off that pitch. You got him leaning, so if you've got a lot of confidence in your breaking ball right now, you can start in the same spot and run it off the plate, or you could start that fastball a little bit more in and run it underneath his hands.
One ball, two strikes to John Layton, two on, two outs. Mules lead 4-1, top of the fourth. Outfield straight away. Ben Kelsch to the plate. Fouled it off again, right off the home plate umpire's mask. So again, 2-2.
And they went back to that fastball in. That's the pitch I like. Now I think you can get him with that breaking ball away here. If you execute it, fastball away, leaning in. He's fought off the inside fastball. I think that outside corner's now back opened up.
Ben Kelsch about to deliver pitch number 74 here in the fourth inning. So he has had a lot of pitches in the first four innings, a lot in the first two. Now 1-2 on Layton. Ben Kelsch to the plate. Strike three called. He did. He needled that outside corner. And Ben Kelsch strikes out Layton for the second time, leaves two men on base for the Lions in the fourth. Missouri Southern does get one on the home run by Matt Miller. We head to the bottom of the fourth inning. Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field. Mules lead Missouri Southern 4-1.
A degree in digital media production with an emphasis in digital cinema will prepare you for all aspects of film production, such as screenwriting, editing, cinematography, and motion graphics. Our faculty members bring real-world experience to the classroom, and students can showcase their work in film festivals, UCM's CTV, and digitalberg.com. For more information on this or other concentrations within the digital media production program, please visit ucmo.edu/DMP.
The two winners of the games today play at noon tomorrow. The two losers come back in an elimination game at 3:30. Then we have another elimination game here tomorrow night at 7. Championship on Saturday at 12 noon. Zach Whalen walked and scored in the second. Whalen takes the first pitch up high. One ball and no strikes. Whalen walked, eventually was cut down at second on a fielder's choice. Whalen hits it slowly towards short. Coffey has time to throw out Zach at first, one down. Parrish really tied up Zach Whalen. So one down for Cole Taylor.
Number nine, Cole Taylor.
Cole rolled into the fielder's choice, 5-4. Back in the second inning that kept down Whalen at second. So lefty-lefty matchup here. Parrish's pitch is in there for a called strike. Parrish works quickly, so the Mules may want to step out on him to give Ben Kelsch an extra breather or two. Pitch pops up on the infield. Coffey, moving out to shallow left field, will make the catch. It's a high sky today, not a cloud in the sky, so that ball can get lost in those blue skies.
Center fielder, number one, Mason
Janvrin. So Parrish working very quickly, already has two outs here in the bottom of the fourth for Mason Janvrin, who has singled and doubled. He has scored one, driven in two. Parrish's pitch is a fastball inside. One ball and no strikes.
And you can just see the easy velocity on that, getting in, popping the glove.
1-0 pitch on the way. Janvrin takes a pitch. That time Parrish kind of just outside of a ball, quick pitched. He did come set. Mason again, 34 of 41 in stolen base attempts this year.
And I like the stolen base attempt right here. If he gets you thrown out, start the inning over next with your hitter.
Pitch way outside. Now a throw. Again, Miller saves a wild throw by Lenz down the right field line that could have been interesting if it goes down the line.
Yeah, so, and that's the second time. Both throws for Lenz to first base, trying to backpick runners. He's missing to the fair territory side, which is tough for that first baseman because you're busting your tail to get to the bag for the tag, and now you got to change direction.
Pitch on the way to Madera. Checks his swing on a pitch high. Janvrin, 34 steals this year, tied for 10th in a single season with Krishner Bush. Harrison's dad did it in 1986, and Chance Tuttle did that in 2009. Two balls, one strike to Madera. They'll throw to first, and Janvrin is back.
Two run right here. Good opportunity, good count for a straight steal or a hit and run. If you're the Mules, just you got a strike throw on the mound and a guy at the plate who doesn't swing and miss too often.
There goes Mason. 2-1 pitch is outside. Throw down to second, and he is out. Excellent throw by Dan Lenz. But again, not a bad try. You get him in scoring position, that's great. If you don't, Madera leads off, and it took a great throw by Lenz to get him, and he did make a perfect throw. So Janvrin cut down trying to steal. Mules get a hit, but no runs in the fourth. We head now to the top of the fifth. Mules lead 4-1.
Let's go, baby. Let's go. Hey.
We haven't had temperatures like this all year, and Ron's going to be the home plate umpire's best friend today.
Yeah, and he is taking some shots early in this game, foul tips or anything like that. So it's plus the heat. Yeah, it's all the gear on, and of course they're wearing their dark tops today. The umpires are, that is. So maybe tomorrow they'll consider wearing maybe some blues or something like that to keep themselves cool. Or
well, Dane Lindsay made the great go down to second to cut down Mason Jan for trying to steal. We'll lead things off for the Lions here at the top of the fifth. Mules on top 4-1. Lenz grounded out to Alex Madera at short in the third. Ben Kelsch's first pitch in there for a strike. Ben needs a quick inning like he got in the third when he only threw eight pitches. The Mules have sent some guys down to the bullpen. They want to get them ready to go just in case. 0-1 pitch to Lenz, squares to bunt, and bunts it great. Snurbush picks, throws to first in time. Great play by Snurbush. Lenz, being a catcher, doesn't run all that great, but he laid down a perfect bunt. Took a great play by Snurbush, and he made it.
Yeah, perfect bunt right there by Lenz. But as you mentioned, it took a perfect play, and Snurbush coming in, fields it barehanded, one step, throws across his body a strike to the big Cole Taylor at first base for the first out.
So one away from Mike Million, the leadoff hitter, a strikeout and a pop-up today. Pitch to Million, good breaking ball in there for a strike. Million struck out in the first on a 3-2 pitch that was up and in. Then hit a limp little pop-up to sinks at second. In the third, big sweeping breaking ball outside. Saw Million take Jonathan Sprinkle deep for the first time. Sprinkle's given up a home run this year in the game on Sunday. One ball, one strike. Kelsch's pitch, ground ball to short. Madera will throw to first. Low throw, but scooped up by Taylor. Boy, Isaiah Cole did a good job of making sure he got that low throw from Alex Madera for the second out of the inning. Lions were complaining they thought that Taylor came off the bag too soon.
Yeah, kind of a not necessarily a bang-bang play with the runner, but a bang-bang play with Cole catching that ball and keeping his foot on the bag. He does a good job of staying low and sweeping through that pitch or that low throw.
Two out now for Freddie Landers, who takes a late call strike. Landers single to right in the first, grounded out to third in the third. Ben Kelsch, 0-1 pitch to Freddie Landers. Same spot, outside corner. So good job by Kelsch to jump out in front of Landers, 0-2. So let's see if Ben can make this a very quick inning. Nothing and two on Landers. Here is the pitch. Just protecting the plate, rolls it over to his third base coach. And we'll do it again, nothing and two. Lions making their third trip to the NCAA postseason under their head coach Bryce Starnell, who played for the Lions in a postseason as well. 0-2 pitch, little tapper over the pitcher's head, sinks in quickly, throws to first, and it is a 1-2-3 fifth inning for Ben Kelsch and the Mules. Three ground balls and three outs. We head to the bottom of the fifth in game one of this NCAA Division II Central Subregional. The Mules leading Missouri Southern 4-1.
A degree in digital media production with an emphasis in live studio remote will enhance your knowledge in multi-camera studio shows as well as multi-camera live event productions. Our professors bring real-world experience into the classroom and students can showcase their work through different media outlets including live streaming, UCMCTV, and digitalberg.com. For more information on this or other concentrations, please visit ucmo.edu/DMP.
Equity Bank, the official bank of Team Spirit. Get your Mule debit card at Equity Bank in Missouri today. Equity Bank, Warrensburg, Sedalia, and throughout Central Missouri, equitybank.com. Madera, Webb, and Snurbush against left-hander Zach Parrish here in the fifth. Madera was at the plate when Mason Janvern was caught stealing in the fourth inning. Bob Jackson, Alex Kent from the broadcast booth at Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field.
Alex Madera.
Connor Cummings, our studio engineer. Mules, 4 runs, 7 hits, no errors. The Lions run 5 hits and no errors. First pitch to Madera, slow breaking ball inside for a ball. Madera, Webb, and Snurbush. Anybody gets on, Michael sinks here in the bottom of the fifth. Pitch is fouled back as Madera got tied up with a fastball from Parrish.
And once again, still this inning, Missouri Southern does have a couple guys down their bullpen, a righty who is just kind of standing around right now.
Good pitch inside corner for a strike. Now 1-2. Tough spot for Bryce Darnell. You want your best guy out there, but you're down 3 here in the fifth. But still, Madera checks his swing at a high fastball. They appealed. He did not swing. But should the Mules get something going and score maybe a run or two, that might be the telltale sign. Pitch to Madera, checks his swing high. Now a full count, 3-2.
Yeah, and I think he's your guy, so you want to ride him as long as you can. But if your offense isn't going to score runs, you might be able to use him later.
Line shot is going to be fouled, as that time Madera got it in on him, and he got the bat through the zone but pulled it foul.
You know, and it might not be to start another game. It might just be it coming out of the right bullpen. You know, in a championship game, something like that, you know, if you get there. But, you know, really it's my philosophy is you got to win your games to get there, so you got to take care of this one.
Payoff pitch is high ball 4. Good at bat by Alex Madera to walk to start here in the bottom of the fifth inning. You know, the first two games in a tournament, double elimination are your most important games. The first game, yes, but the second game is too. Then you're in the championship. Otherwise, you've still got to win 3 additional games. If you lose this game, you got to win 4. So
yep,
we can talk about it all the time. These first games are real important. Oh, big lead by Madera at first base as Eric Webb takes a pitch high for a ball. I was shocked that Parrish didn't throw to first, and now Dan Lenz is going out to the mound. I looked up, Alex, and saw the lead that Madera had and was shocked that there was no throw to first base.
Yeah, he had 1 foot on the green turf and 1 foot on the brown, the sliding pit of first base, you would say. So, you know, the Mules, I think, being more aggressive as this game's gone along. We've seen Lenz with a couple back pick throws, and maybe the Mules trying to turn up that pressure just a little bit.
Eric Webb, who has singled and grounded to third. Madera with the lead. The pitch to Webb is hit in the air into center field. Pretty well hit. Million going back. Has it measured. Makes the catch. And Madera has to head back to first base. Eric kind of hit that off the front foot, maybe off the end of the bat a little bit, and wasn't able to quite pull it.
Yeah, just out in front a little bit and hit it to the big part of the yard. He's able to kind of hook that ball. That ball's got a chance to get up out of here with the wind, but that's the big part of the yard. That's where you want as a pitcher. You want guys to hit it to the scoreboard and to right field, center field today.
So now one out for Harrison Snurbush. Right-handed batter, pitch to Snurbush, is low and inside for a ball. Snurbush in this ball game has fly to right and single. Mules have hit .335 against the Lions in their previous 5 ball games. Pitch on the way. Snurbush fouls it back. These two teams have combined for 23 home runs in their 5 games plus with Miller's home run today. Mules had 10. Lions now have 13. Most of those came in that weekend series in Joplin back in early April. 1-1 to Snurbush. Throw to first. Madera back. Alex, 8 stolen bases. He has been gunned down 9 times, however. One ball, 1 strike. Madera with the lead. Here's the pitch. And a line shot into left field by Snurbush as Parrish left that up. So Snurbush, a 2-hit ball game. Mules have first and second with 1 away for Michael Sinks.
Second baseman is number 6, Michael Sinks.
Sinks has struck out and hit into a fielder's choice. So Michael up there with an RBI opportunity. Sinks has done well against the Lions this year. Coming into this game, 10 of 24, 3 home runs, 9 driven in. Runners lead away first and second. Little blooper. Shallow left field. That's going to be down. Madera read it well. He will round third and score easily as the throw comes to the plate. Michael Sinks bloops a single into left field, and the Mules now lead 5-1.
Yeah, great read by Madera at second base right there. He's almost, he turns, finds the baseball, sees it's going to be down, because with that wind blowing, the left fielder is playing pretty deep. Yeah, and with that throw all the way to the plate, I know being around Coach Crook so often, he's happy they scored a run there, but he's also like, Harry, get to third base on that throw. No cutoff man was in sight for the Lions, so the Lions catch a break there.
First and second, one out now for Schumacher, who is singled and grounded to first. First and second, one out. Schumacher takes a good fastball to the outside corner for a strike. Five runs, nine hits now for the Mules, who lead the Lions 5-1. Boy, they would like to have Schumacher maybe send Zach Parrish to the dugout with a big hit here. Nothing and one. Parrish's pitch. Line shot, left center field. That is down. And that is going to be another run for the Mules. Runner going to third. Sinks a safe. Schumacher to second base. And Josh Schumacher does come up with a big hit. And the Mules now lead 6-1 on their 10th hit of the ball game.
And that's the example of what Coach Crooks was looking for. And we are going to get a visit from head coach Bryce Darnell. And I would assume with the Mules extending their lead, going to go ahead and make that change here like we've been talking about. But, you know, Sinks gets a, you know, first off, you start with Schumacher. Great job of staying inside that pitch from Parrish. You know, we talk about it, he's so tough to pick up and hit. He's got such easy, good stuff that as a lefty, it can be tough to keep your front side in. Schumacher shoots the ball into left center and then Sinks with the play in front of him, goes first to third pretty easily. And the center fielder, Million, who has a great arm, throws the ball up over the cutoff man's head. So then Schumacher running out of the box, able to roll into second base, and the Mules are rolling here with only one out.
New pitcher coming on for Missouri Southern with one out in the bottom of the fifth. Mules lead 6-1. We'll give you the numbers on the new Lions pitcher after this from Fitter's Restaurant and Pub on Pine Street in Warrensburg.
Fitter's Restaurant and Pub on Pine Street in downtown Warrensburg has been setting the standard for good times and great food since 1996. Voted the best bar in town, Fitter's features two floors, three full bars, outdoor seating, pool tables, and NTN trivia. Watch your favorite sporting event on one of the many HD flat screen TVs. Fitter's Restaurant and Pub serves a full menu, including the best pizza and wings in the burg. For lunch, dinner, and late night, it's Fitter's Restaurant and Pub on Pine Street in downtown Warrensburg.
Right-hander Bradley Hershey comes out of the bullpen for Missouri Southern. 6'2 senior from Coffeyville, Kansas. Mules got a full look at him in Pittsburgh, Kansas, as he gave the Lions 7 1/3 innings of 6 hit, 1 run, 3 walk, 6 strikeout relief, and got the win when the Lions beat the Mules 5-4 on Saturday in Pittsburgh, Kansas. So the numbers were good on Saturday. Now, you've seen him enough here, Alex. You think that Mules may think, okay, we've seen him, we know what he can do, but he's done a good job against the Mules really all year in two previous appearances. So he's a tough kid. He's obviously much different from Zach Parrish. Number one, he's a right-hander, and he comes kind of sidearm.
Yeah, he's a low sidearm guy. Not fully submarine, but pretty darn close to it. You know, and this is another guy that me and Coach Crooks talked about. I visited with him in his office yesterday. And, you know, it was one of those things where they knew that they had their hands full with Parrish, and they've done a great job of handling him today, 10 hits, 6 runs. But this was another guy that he was expecting to see early on in the game because he's such, with the Mules' right-handed stacked lineup, he's a tough guy to pick up the ball against and, once again, keep that front side in on. And one out here, Donovan Ditto stepping to the plate. Southern is going to bring their infield in as they see this game on the verge of getting out of hand.
So Hershey on to pitch, infield in against Ditto, who has been hit by a pitch and struck out. Pitch on the way, ground ball up the middle, base hit. That will plate a couple of runs for the Mules, who is going to increase their lead to 8-1. Donovan Ditto, first pitch he sees, you know, Alex, he's looking for maybe a first pitch fastball, got it. And with the infield in, that middle part of the infield is the biggest hole.
And Donovan has been first pitch all day today. Parrish was able to throw changeups early to get him out front. Hershey right there, first pitch fastball, and Ditto stays middle of the field there and gets rewarded with a 2 RBI base hit.
So Zach Parrish is done as far as his numbers. 8 runs in a game. I have to go back on his stats, but I would say that's probably the most he's given up Zach Whalen swings at the first pitch and skies it. Foul territory, going to be a tough play. Hunter in pursuit, and that's going to fall foul and just out of play as a B2 flies over the left field wall. That's a beautiful view. I hope people see that. We see it all the time, get kind of spoiled by it, but it never gets old.
I look down here, and you got the guys from St. Cloud are sitting on the first base side, and all of their heads are just up watching that thing bank around. I'm like, you know, Warrensburg, we're the only, you know, Crane Stadium, the only place that gets a flyover from a B2 every day, it seems like.
Yep. So flyover for the game a little bit late, but that's okay. Ditto the lead at first. Pitch to Whalen's, fouled off by the Mules dugout.
But it never gets old, does it?
It never does, nope. It,
if I'm outside mowing the yard playing and you hear those things, you look up and it's just amazing.
Yeah, it is never something you never look up at. And we are fortunate to be able to see that on a daily basis. Whalen, right-handed batter, Brad Hershey. Overhand breaking ball is high. Now, he normally comes sidearm. That time he went right over the top. But the pitch stayed up. 8 runs, 11 hits for the Mules. 8-1 lead, a 4 spot here in the fifth inning. Ditto the lead at first. Hershey will throw over. Hershey came on in relief of starter for Missouri Southern on Saturday. And Joey Reeves, he was just outstanding. 1-2 pitch way outside. Mules in that ballgame, it seemed like they were trying to elevate pitches and hit them out of the park at Al Lord Alani Field, and they were popping up, flying out, and just getting frustrated. 2 balls, 2 strikes. The pitch on the way. Whalen swings, and foul tipped it. Just barely stayed alive as Ditto was running.
Once again, Hershey comes a little bit more over the top. Traditional arm angle there with that overhand curveball, and Whalen able to fight off that tough 2-2 pitch.
So 2 balls and 2 strikes on Zach. Ditto the lead at first. Hershey's pitch on the way. Little blooper. Shallow center field. That is down for another hit. The Mules are killing the Lions softly here in the fifth inning with balls that have not really been hit that hard, Alex, but they've been placed well.
And sometimes you just have those days. We've seen the Mules offense a lot this year barrel up a lot of baseballs and hit a lot of baseballs hard, and some of them for outs. And you have days where you get a bloop, and let's see if Cole Taylor, who should be able to pick up this ball out of Hershey's hand pretty easily, can supply a blast.
Cole is hit into a fielder's choice and popped to short. Runners lead away at first and second. Backdoor breaking ball from Hershey is in there for a called strike. Hershey 5-1, 4.32 ERA, 33 strikeouts, 16 walks. Again, he's from Coffeyville, Kansas. Runners lead away at first and second. Nothing and one on Taylor. Taylor way out in front, swings and misses, and now Ditto tried to steal, is going to be caught in a rundown. Throw down to second, and Ditto was out. Donovan just kind of got over aggressive again that time. The pitch was down, but it was not going to be one that was going to get away from the catcher.
Yeah, I think once again, that's just the frustration of not being able to straight steal. You want to be aggressive. You want to get to the next base, especially get to third base with less than two outs, and you, instead of trusting your eyes, you roll through a pitch that you think is going to get away.
0-2 to Taylor. There's a base hit up the middle. Wow. That would have scored another run, but, and again, the ball not hit very hard, but placed perfectly by Taylor. So with Ditto being caught trying to steal, it cost the Mules a run. So Taylor at first, Whalen goes to second. Every Mule has a hit in this ballgame, and Mason Janvern has 3 hits. So he has 3 out of 3 with 1 run scored, 2 RBIs. Hits to Mason, laid on a fastball from Hershey. It's nothing and one. Hershey had 7 strikeouts in his 3 appearances against the Mules this year, and 8 1/3. It's a 1-1 record. Pitch on the way, got tied up. Mason rolls it foul.
One thing that we haven't really seen from Hershey that you typically see from guys who throw from down there is we've seen the fastball, the good sinking fastball. We haven't seen that frisbee-like slider It looks like every breaking ball he's thrown that I can see has been more over the top.
Pitch coming to Janvier, and he comes over the top of the fastball and throws it high. Yeah, one ball and two strikes. Janvier, the ninth man to bat here in this fifth inning. Mules have scored four. They have two more men out there. The Mules have stranded three in the first four innings. One and two on Janvier. Runners lead away. Pitch on the way again. High to Mason. It's two and two. Mason drove in the game winner in the elimination game Sunday against Missouri Southern. Zach Whalen, the runner at second. Cole Taylor at first.
And Whalen's doing a good job of getting some of Hershey's attention.
Hershey a peek back to Zach. Here's the pitch to Mason. Checked his swing and a pitch low and away. So now from 0-2 to 3-2 for Mason Janvier.
And that's a big 2-2 ball right there, because now you get two of the slower runners on the Mules team get a head start on this 3-2 pitch.
Runners go 3-2 to Mason. Strike three called inside corner. Mason didn't think so, but Bradley got the call on that inside corner to Mason. So nine to the plate in the fifth. The Mules score four, leave two.
Did you know
we will head to the top of the sixth here at Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Mules have an 8-1 lead over Missouri Southern. Before we continue with more baseball, let's pause 15 seconds for station identification. You're listening to UCM Mules Baseball.
You're listening to UCM Athletics on 1450 KOKO Warrensburg and 98.5 The Bar KWKJ Windsor Warrensburg Sedalia. UCM Athletics brought to you by Central Bank with six locations to better serve you. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom Jackson, Alex Kent with you from Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field. Connor Cummings, our studio engineer. The Mules hosting their first NCAA Division II regional since 2012 here at this lovely ballpark. They lead 8-1 over Missouri Southern. Troy Gagan to lead things off. First pitch from Ben Kelsch inside for a ball. 83 pitches for Ben to start this sixth inning. Mules have some guys in their bullpen, but all sitting right now. 1-0 pitch. Gagan rolls this one to short. Madera's to back up. Almost let it eat him up. Low throw, but Taylor digs it out. Boy, you could see the panic, I think, on Alex Madera, Alex, when he realized he was going to have to play that short hop and had to hurry that throw.
Yeah, he got caught in between there. It was, do I take maybe one and a half more steps and pick through that, or do I drop step? And he just kind of froze. Luckily, good hands and a good throw, and Cole Taylor staying on the bag to scoop that low throw.
So here is Matt Miller, who has accounted for the only run, and now he laces this one to right field, but right at Eric Webb, who makes the catch. So Miller hunting first pitch fastball, dead, but it was kind of down, and all he could do was not elevate it high enough, and a line drive to Webb, quickly two outs, exactly what Ben Kelsch needs.
And that is what we're talking about. You know, his home run last time out was a fastball away. He flicked over. You, if he's going to hit one out, make him earn it, hit it through this wind into right field.
Now Ryan Hunter, who is one out of two. Little blooper is going to fall in. Left center field. Schumacher will get that ball back into the infield. I think the Lions know that Ben Kelsch is going to, now with an 8-1 lead, he is going to try to pound the strike zone.
Yep, and so if you're the Lions, that's good. That means you're going to get a lot of early strikes, but you can also have very quick innings here and keep his pitch count down. So it's that catch 22. Do you want to drive his pitch count up and get in the Mules bullpen, or be a little bit more aggressive? We're seeing him be aggressive here.
So Ben Kelsch gives up his sixth hit of the ball game. Here is Dexter Swim, and a pitch way outside, speared by Zach Whalen. Swim's got an infield hit in the fourth. He is also grounded to second base. One ball, no strikes. Ground ball, high chopper to third. Snurbush will throw to first in time, and it is a very quick top of the sixth inning for Missouri Southern despite the single. Ben Kelsch, just a handful of pitches, exactly what a guy needs with an 8-1 lead on a hot day. Nothing for the Lions in the sixth. They have now stranded a handful. We head to the bottom of the sixth. Mules leading Missouri Southern 8-1.
We have so much to celebrate in Division II, but we're especially proud of our commitment to Make-A-Wish.
Division II student athletes have led a 10-year initiative to raise funds and help grant wishes of children with life-threatening medical conditions.
Nearly $3 million have been raised, and hundreds of children's wishes have been granted.
We play hard, we work hard, and we support others in need. Why? It's simple.
Because we care.
Bryce Darnell's going to go back to his bullpen for new pitcher for Missouri Southern, right-hander Brennan Covington. 6'1 senior from Lenexa, Kansas. Mules saw Brennan Covington as well over the weekend down in Pittsburgh. They saw him actually start the game on Sunday. Pitched two innings, gave up 6 hits, 3 runs. So Brennan Covington, 2-0 on the year with 1 save, 32 strikeouts, just 7 walks. So he is a strike thrower. He will come on to take over for Bradley Hershey. Now I think I can see Bryce Darnell starting to, make some match guys to try to get arms, maybe some experience, and then have some fresh arms here for what could be a long day tomorrow.
Yeah, that's a great point. Plus, it looked like Hershey didn't have his stuff today. So instead of running him back out there and as a bullpen guy, I almost felt better the second day after throwing 15 to 25 pitches. The next day I felt really good, but the third day is when my shoulder really started to tighten up. So everybody's a little bit different, but I think that's what Darnell's looking at here is, all right, let's – it comes down to, is our offense going to score runs because we're down 7. So let's run some guys out there and keep their pitch count low.
Well, 9 came to the plate for the Mules in the fifth, so we'll start over the sixth as we did the fifth. Alex Madera, who walked to start that 6-run inning, or the 4-run inning. Mules did have 6 consecutive hits. Covington's first pitch, good fastball in there for a called strike. It'll be Madera, Webb, and Snurbush here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Covington's pitch, same spot. Called strike, Madera down, nothing and 2. Eric Webb waiting on deck. Covington's 0-2. Madera just protecting the plate, fouls it off.
Yeah, Covington, that right-handed arm, stands on the first base side of the rubber, but when he strides, he lands closer to third base than he does first base, so he throws way across his body and is just picking off that outside corner with fastballs.
Pitch on the way to Madera, high fastball away. 1-2. Madera today has doubled in a run. That was back in the first, popped to short, walked, and scored. 1-2 on the way. Madera just got a piece of it and fouled it back. Count 1-2. Mule scored a run in the first, 2 in the second, 1 in the third. They have been in the lead ever since. Now ball taken back out of the umpire by Mason Green. It's always a starting pitcher's job to take the foul of the new balls out of the umpire. Madera just gets a piece of a pitch and fouls it off. I've always been amazed. Ben Kelsch will do that honor tomorrow. Got to be a part of the team, man.
And I think it's a little bit of a psychological game. You get that umpire to know you.
Yeah, I guess. 1-2 pitch to Madera. Pops this up foul territory. Landers at third base in foul territory to make the catch. So as a pitcher, if you're taking balls out to the umpire to put in his ball bag, you say, here's 3 new baseballs that you probably missed 3 on me last night.
Yeah, it's just hey, nice to meet you. I'm Alex. I'm going to be pitching tomorrow. I'll look forward to working with you type thing.
1-down for Eric Webb, 1-3. Pitch to Webb, barely missed him, hitting him on the inside foot. 1-0. Eric was named the Central Region Player of the Year, by the way. yesterday. So congratulations to the Mules junior. 1-0 pitch gets jammed and rolls it to his head coach, Kyle Crooks, who makes a nice stop. Eric, you know, no longer leads the league in hitting since they extend that into the conference tournament. But during the regular season, Eric was the Triple Crown winner. Home runs, RBIs, and average. Swing and a miss there by Webb. He's down 1-2. 10th MIAA Player of the Year in Mules history. The last to do it was Brett Schwartz in 2012. 1-2 on Eric Webb, and he swings at a pitch way outside. Throw to first by Lenz in time. Eric over-aggressive there, strikes himself out. So two down. That'll bring up Harrison Snurbush.
Yeah, Webb was having a tough time trying to pick up that ball once again. He throws so far against his body. He picks off that outside corner. He'll throw a good overhand kind of power curveball. It's not really a slider. It's more of a 12-6, 1-7 break on the clock.
Snurbush has singles in his last two at-bats. Skevington throws a good fastball to the outside corner, nothing and one. 2-for-3 today for the Mules' third baseman. Snurbush on a breaking ball, swings and misses. So Covington very effective here in the sixth. Trying to retire the Mules in order for the first time without a man reaching base. Breaking ball low and outside, 1-2. The Mules only sent 3 to the plate in the fourth after Janvern singled. He was gunned down trying to steal. 1-2. Covington to the plate. Breaking ball didn't swing. The pitch stayed low. Even 2-2. Snurbush keeps the inning going. Michael Sinks waiting on deck. He would bat. And Covington's 2-2 pitch. Down low. So from 0-2 now to 3-2. And Harrison showing good discipline to not swing at those last couple of breaking balls. Let's see if Covington tries to get the fastball over. Payoff pitch coming. Strike 3 call. Good fastball, but he got it on the outside corner. Good location. So Brendan Covington coming out of the bullpen to strike out 2 in the inning and retire the Mules in order in the sixth. Game 1 of this NCAA Division II Sub-Regional here at Crane Stadium. Tompkins Field heads to the top of the seventh. It's the Mules on top of the Lions, 8-1.
A degree in digital media production with an emphasis in digital journalism will develop your skill set for work in multimedia outlets, including print, online, and broadcast. Our faculty members bring real-world experience to the classroom, and students can showcase their work online at digitalberg.com and in the student-led newspaper, The Mule Skinner. For more information on this or other concentrations within the digital media production program, please visit ucmo.edu/DMP.
Innings where he has not had to throw as many pitches, which is good. Then a week ago through 6 1/3 against Missouri Western, he has one complete game to his credit this year. His last three outings have been a complete game, 8 2/3 and 6 1/3. He threw 89 pitches against Missouri Western a week ago, and he is at 89 to start this inning. First pitch to Denver Coffee has popped up foul, and that'll get out of play. Coffee has struck out and single. There's a difference, I guess, Alex, in number of pitches and stress pitches that you throw, though, right?
Yeah, I think so. Early on in this ball game, a lot of stressful pitches those first two innings, but as the Mules have been able to extend their lead, it's been a lot of early count ground balls.
Pitch on the way, hit in the air, right center field. Janvern running over, headlong dive. It's Webb to make the catch. I was watching Mason Janvern, but Eric Webb was the guy that was cutting in from right field and made a diving play to take a hit away from Denver Coffee.
You know, and we can't hear the communication going on between the two, but you could kind of see Mason was getting into that mode of, I'm getting ready to leave my feet. Webb calls it, and Mason pulls up. If he misses it, Mason was there to keep the runner at first base, but great headlong dive by Eric Webb for the first out of the inning.
We have a pinch hitter now coming up for Alex Phillips, left-handed batter batting. Swings at the first pitch, pops it up, twisting foul territory. Mules have Snurbush running after it and makes the catch. Alex Phillips, left-handed batter, seeing his first action, swings at the first pitch and dials out to Snurbush. Quickly, two down.
The catcher, number 18, Dan Lenz.
Exactly again what Ben Kelsch needs. Another quick inning as the catcher, Dan Lenz, who is 0 for 2, two groundouts. Bat here at the top of the seventh. And Ben throws a letter high strike. No other reason now but Ben Kelsch just to pound that strike zone. Try to use that sinker to get ground balls and see if Missouri Southern, knowing he's going to throw strikes, will be aggressive. Another strike outside corner. Lenz has it offered.
And that's what you do if you're Ben Kelsch. You just keep pouring it in there, quality pitches. You use that sinker and let them hit their way back into this ballgame.
0-2 pitch. Lenz fights it off and fouls it right side.
You know, one thing that about the Lions, they hit a lot of home runs. They do strike out a lot, but they also walk a lot. So when you get them down early and they've got to hit their way back in, that kind of takes a portion of their game out. They like to be patient at the plate. Now they have to be aggressive.
Nothing in two here on Lenz. Breaking ball just outside and low. Lenz thought about it, then thought about it again and didn't offer. Ben laid it in a great spot, but it was off the plate low. Now it's one ball and two strikes. Lenz, the number nine hitter for the Lions, protecting the plate again with a high fastball, just fouls it back. Lions have had hits in every inning, but the third and fifth. They have a half a dozen hits in this ballgame. Their only run, a solo home run for Matt Miller in the top of the fourth inning. Another breaking ball way outside. Evens the count at 2-2. This is going to be pitch number 98 for Ben Kelsch. Again, nobody warming for the Mules in their bullpen. Pitch on the way. Ground ball going to be foul wide of third. Mike Millian, the leadoff hitter, waits on deck for Missouri Southern. You know, Lions one game behind the Mules in the MIAA regular season. Central Oak, who is also here, finished two games behind the Mules. The top three teams in the league are all here. 2-2 pitch, hit in the air to right. Eric Webb hardly has to move except a couple of steps in. Makes the catch, and the inning is over. So a 1-2-3, top of the seventh, seventh inning stretch at Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field. Game one of this NCAA Division II Central Subregional. The Mules, the number two seed, lead the number seven seed Missouri Southern Lions 8-1.
I support one student in college with a scholarship. Just the way I want to pass on a legacy of education, I would like to pass PBS on to the next generation.
For more information, call 1-800-753-3436.
I like to think that PBS is concerned with our soul. If your soul is in the right place, you're giving back.
Bottom of the seventh, Brennan Covington will start his second inning in relief for the Lions. Mules on top 8-1. Sinks, Schumacher, and Ditto, the scheduled batters here in the bottom of inning number seven. Western Missouri Medical Center is your partner for health. Advanced medicine closer to home. Visit WMMC.com today. Western Missouri Medical Center, the official health care provider for UCM Athletics. Mills retired in 1-2-3 fashion by Covington in the sixth. He'll deal with 5, 6, and 7 here in the bottom of the seventh. Michael Sinks, who is 1-for-3, will lead things off. Covington's first pitch is a breaking ball that stayed up. One ball and no strikes. Mills in their 30th. NCAA regional, 72-26, their all-time record in regional games. Sinks led in a fastball, swings and misses. Mules are trying to win their 18th regional championship to advance to the Division II baseball championships. Last time, of course, that happened, 2016. Sinks, high fastball swing and kind of a half-hearted swing, is down now, one ball and two strikes. One 2 pitch on the way. Sinks protecting the plate. Hits it toward right field. Gagan will make a catch, one away. So Covington out of the bull tip pin to retire four straight. This is the second straight regional the Mules have appeared in. Last year, of course, we made that trip to McNulty, Arkansas. Mules won their first two games before losing in the semifinals to eventual national champion Augustana, and then got eliminated by Southern Arkansas. Josh Schumacher at the plate, two out of three. His time is called. He said the last time the Mules hosted the regional was 2012. The last regional win came in 2016 in St. Cloud, Minnesota. St. Cloud State is here for this sub-regional. First pitch to Schumacher, laid on a fastball, hits it foul off the left side. St. Cloud State and Central Oklahoma will play the night game tonight. First pitch scheduled for 7 o'clock. And a full day of baseball tomorrow. 0-1 pitch outside. The two winners of today's game play at noon tomorrow. The two losers come back at 3:30 tomorrow for elimination game number one. And then there'll be another elimination game tomorrow night at 7. 1-1 pitch outside. 2-1. Championship Saturday is on the schedule right now. The weather Saturday is iffy. It's a pretty good chance of some rain Saturday, and depends on when it starts. There is a rain date built into this on Sunday. 2-1 pitch on the way. Schumacher swinging a miss as Covington pulled the string.
Yeah, good back foot breaking ball right there, and we've seen Covington really attack the right-handed hitters away, 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 but here to Schumacher, the lefty, has been away to the arm side of the plate.
2-2 pitch coming. Tried the backdoor breaking ball and stayed high and away. So now the count full, three balls and two strikes. The other Central Sub-Regional being hosted by number one seed and defending national champ Augustana in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, starting today. Payoff pitch coming to Schumacher. Struck him out on a high fastball. So Brennan Covington out of the bullpen to retire five in a row. He has calmed this Mules offense down.
And his stuff has been electric. He's not doing anything too special. It's getting ahead with the fastball and throwing the breaking ball with a good snap to keep these Mules hitters, guessing at the plate.
Donovan Ditto had a two-run single his last at bat. He is one out of two today. And a swing and a miss. Covington just throwing hard right now. Mules lit up the MIAA Pitcher of the Year, first-team All-Region left-hander Zach Parrish for 8 runs today on 10 hits. Good breaking ball in there for a strike. Covington, though, has looked like the best pitcher we've seen today. He's really looked good. Trying to make it a quick bottom of the seventh. 0-2 pitch, breaking ball way outside. Yeah. Arkansas Monticello, by the way, in that first game in Augustana in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, was leading Minnesota State 7-2. They're in the sixth inning. Augustana plays Oklahoma Baptist tonight. Breaking ball got up, and Donovan Ditto singles into left field. Good bat control, Alex, by Donovan to make sure he didn't overswing on that.
Yeah, and he was on time for the fastball, and he saw the breaking ball up out of the hand of Covington, able to keep his hands back just enough to serve it into left field. And when you got a guy that throws a plus fastball, you got to get in a hurry to be on time with it. Covington does him a favor by hanging that breaking ball.
So a runner at first base for the Mules, their 14th hit today. Here is Zach Whalen, one out of two. Whalen takes a fastball high and away, one ball and no strikes. Again, every Mule has a hit today. Every Mule except Zach Whalen has either scored or driven in a run. Ditto, the runner at first. One ball, no strikes. The pitch to Zach. Another high fastball, 2-0.
And this is the first time we've seen him coming down out of the stretch. You can tell he's a little uncomfortable, kind of rushing to the plate. And that's what a team like the Mules can do to you. When you get a runner on base and you know it's a likelihood that they're going to steal, that pitcher starts to rush to the plate. Pitches get elevated. Hitters get better pitches to hit.
Two balls and no strikes on Zach Whalen. Dane Lenz out to the mound to visit with his right-hander.
And I like that visit there by Lenz. Just slow him down a little bit. See, he's getting in a hurry and kind of hit the reset button and, hey, go get your guy right here.
2-0 on Zach. Ditto again, the lead at first base. Covington, from the stretch, gives a peek, pitch on the way, and a swing and a miss on a high fastball. Covington is getting it up there in a hurry.
Yeah, this Missouri Southern pitching staff, they've got a lot of guys that have some what we would call power arms, a lot of high 80s, and they've got some guys that can run it up there 93-94.
2-1 to Whalen. Ditto again, the lead at first. Good breaking ball by Covington. Had Zach really fooled, couldn't offer. Now from 2-0 to 2-2. So after the visit by Dan Lenz, Covington has really settled in.
You know, hitting can look so easy at times, and it can look almost nearly impossible when you got a guy with velocity and can do that, snap off a good breaking ball.
Two balls, two strikes on Whalen. Fastball away, it's 3-2. So Ditto will have the added advantage of running on this 3-2 pitch. And the Mules could tack on another run if Whalen could find a gap. The outfield is straight away and deep on this warm, humid Thursday. Payoff pitch, runner goes, and a swing and a miss as Covington just blew it by Zach. A couple of strikeouts. Covington has four strikeouts in two innings. Mules get ahead. They leave one. Mules have now stranded a half a dozen through seven. We head to the top of the eighth, Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field. The Mules lead Missouri Southern 8-1.
A degree in digital media production with an emphasis in sports communication will enhance your knowledge in multi-camera live sports productions, in addition to writing for sports media. Our faculty members bring real-world experience to the classroom, and students can showcase their work through different media outlets, including live streaming under the MIAA network, UCM CTV, and digitalberg.com. For more information on this, please visit ucmo.edu/DMP.
Sporting events and enjoy some great, great food and atmosphere and traditions out of the Mules National Golf Club. Like Traditions on Facebook and follow them on Twitter for all of their fantastic information. It's kind of warm to be maybe on the patio today, but hey, it never beats a bad day to be out there and enjoy great scenery, great food, and great atmosphere. Not a bad atmosphere here either. Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field hosting this NCAA Division II Central Sub-Regional. The number two seed Mules on top of the Lions, 8-1. Top of the order for Missouri Southern against Ben Kelsch, who is right at 100 pitches.
Number four, Mike Million,
Landers, and Gagan. 1, 2, and 3 in the lineup for Missouri Southern. Mike Million, 0-3. Ben Kelsch, first pitch, is rolled to short. Madera has to backhand, now bobbles, throws to first, and not in time. That should be an error on Madera, who had a play. Just all he did, had to do, was make the play, and he came up on his arm a little bit. So Million reaches. And here is Freddie Landers. So the Mules, who this year struggled defensively, that is their 61st error, or make that their 76th error. Mules were 7th in the league with a .962 fielding percentage. Freddie Landers now reaches for one, blows into the right field, caught by Webb. Looked like he might want to throw back to Cole Taylor at first, but Million, able to read it, gets back to first. It's two pitches, should be two outs.
Right fielder,
and that can definitely be a frustrating part, but, you know, that's part of the game, right? You know, yep. Madera just kind of sloppy footwork and doesn't get in front of that ball and nonchalance it. But Kelsch picks him up and gets the second or the first out.
Now Troy Gagan, who swings at the first pitch and hits it to right field. Ben Kelsch is saying, you know what? I'm going to throw strikes. You hit him. Webb makes the catch. Three pitches and now two outs. So he had 100 pitches, Alex, coming into this inning. He has three in this inning. And the Mules, why put anybody up in the bullpen right now? If you get a complete game in the first game of the regional, that's a big plus.
Well, and I look at it this way. One, if you win and you take care of business this weekend, he gets an extra day of rest because you don't start next weekend until Friday. So pitch count can kind of go up a little bit.
Matt Miller, left-handed batter, swings at the first pitch and fouls it off. If you know they're swinging at the first pitch, you still want to throw that strike, though, don't you? You still want to pound that strike zone.
Absolutely, and it's quality pitches.
Yeah.
Quality pitches, and that's what he's doing right now. He's done a good job of the first two innings, it was a lot of 3-2 pitches, a lot of struggle, but he's made the adjustment.
Nothing and one on Miller. Tried to hit the backdoor breaking ball outside corner and missed. Miller homered in the fourth, opposite field. His 12th home run this year. So that is the first pitch Lions hitter has taken here in the eighth inning. One ball, one strike. The pitch on the way. Miller takes the pitch at the letters for a strike.
You know, and I like keeping Kelsch in this ball game. As he's, you know, cruising right along. He's doing what he's supposed to do. I'm not a big fan of just giving Missouri Southern a different look for a different look, because that could be flip a switch for him.
1-2 pitch outside for a ball. One ball and two strikes. Matt Miller, by the way, is only a freshman. He's from Aurora, Missouri. Lions have a couple of really good freshmen. Dexter Swims, their second baseman, and Miller, their first baseman. Two balls, two strikes to Miller. Million, the runner at first. Here is the pitch. High pop foul, out of play off the left side again.
You know, Bryce Darnell, since getting there, has done a good job of recruiting talented guys and getting them to buy in. And, you know, their team identity, he's really, I think he's kind of modeling it after what has been successful here at Central Missouri. It's go get you top-end pitchers, go get you guys that can run and defend. And now this year they hit it out of the ballpark, but that's never a bad thing.
Two balls and two strikes to Miller. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball low and inside. So it's a full count on Matt Miller, with Million the runner at first. Bryce Darnell played for the veteran, of course, Warren Turner, who was head coach at Missouri Southern for so many years. Payoff pitch with a runner going, and that ball is hit in the air to right, but got it off the end of the bat. Eric Webb is going to make the catch. Webb records all three outs in the eighth inning. As a matter of fact, Webb has now caught the last three innings. He has six outs himself in right field. So a leadoff error doesn't hurt the Mules. Million is stranded. Mules came to bat. Bottom of the eighth. Mules on top, 8-1.
We can stop to make sure someone is okay.
Get in the way and disrupt the situation.
Notify an authority.
Or walk them home safely.
We can change the language around rape.
We can make campuses safer for our teammates, our friends, and our classmates.
We cannot be bystanders.
Taking action isn't always easy, but it's on us
to intervene.
Because we can.
Learn more and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
John of Albert Accounting and Tax in Warrensburg specializes in tax preparation for individuals, LLC, partnerships, and corporations. If your business needs assistance in payroll and bookkeeping, then you need John of Albert Accounting and Tax, located at 454 East Gay or 429-4495. John of Albert Accounting and Tax, small town business, big time service. Cole Taylor will lead things off against Brennan Cunnington. Two innings, 37 pitches, four strikeouts, giving up one hit. He came on after the Mules scored four in the fifth to open this up to an 8-1 ballgame. Covington's first pitch to Taylor, high for a ball. Mason Janvern and Alex Madero will follow. Anybody gets on, Eric Webb to bat here in the bottom of the eighth. Taylor pops this up. Covington jammed him. Denver Coffey, the shortstop's going to give way to the left fielder, Hunter, to make the catch. Again, they call this a high sky. There's not a cloud in the sky. It's blue. It can really cause problems if you don't follow that ball from the back.
You know, if you're a fan of old baseball stadiums, the Metrodome in Minnesota is one that comes to mind. The ball gets up there, and you kind of lose your depth perception of it.
Mason Janvern had a big cut at a high fastball from Covington and fouled it back. Mason, a three-hit game. 3-for-4, 2 RBIs and a run scored. So Mason now in 96 hits this season. 0-1 pitch. Mason takes a high fastball. One ball, one strike. Mason led the MIAA in hits, stolen bases, and runs. He's currently third in average. High pitch, two balls, one strike. It is a rarity to see a 100-hit season in college baseball, but Mason's climbing toward that. 2-1 pitch, outside. Three balls and one strike. By the way, congratulations to Mason Janvern. He's all-academic district. He and Haley Crabtree from Jenny's softball earning that honor. Mason, big cut, foul it back. By the way, Jenny's golf today wrapped up their first ever NCAA Division II National Championship tournament. In program history, they finished 15th. Great start for building from that for head coach Chris Port. Payoff pitch coming to Mason, fouls it right side. Yeah. Now UCM track and field getting ready to send several student athletes to the National Championships outdoor track and field here in a couple of weeks.
I saw the MIAA itself as a conference had over 125 student athletes qualify, and the next closest was in the 80s.
Yeah. Payoff pitch again coming to Mason. Struck him out with a high fastball. Mason strikes out for the second time. There are two outs. That's now five strikeouts in the game for
seven, Alex Madera.
Brennan Covington, as Alex Madera will step up.
Just shows you the athletes, the student athletes that call the MIAA conference home, and it's impressive.
Madera is one out of three. Swings at the first pitch. It's to Landers at third. Throw across in time, and the inning is over. By the way, the official number on the Mules are sending 10 men, male track and field athletes in 15 events. Jenny's will send three and four events May 24th through the 26th in Kingsville, Texas. 1, 2, 3, Mules down.
We are Mules. Over the past 150 years, nothing has gotten in the way of our success. Not wars, not a fire that burned down our campus, and certainly not a virus. In 1918, the Spanish flu also forced us to close our doors. But we didn't call it quits then, and we're not stopping now. Together, we will come back stronger to graduate with meaningful degrees and make a difference. We are the University of Central Missouri, and we are Mule Strong.
Bob Jackson, Alex Kent for the broadcast booth at Crane Stadium, Tompkins Field. Connor Cummings, our studio engineer. We head to the top of the ninth. 8-1 lead for the Mules over Missouri Southern. And Ben Kelsch trying to.
My agent was there before the
final. Go the complete game here as Eric Webb will lead things off. First pitch is going to be low for a ball. Take that back. I'm looking at the Mules score sheet. Of course, it's not Eric Webb. It's Ryan. It's going to land in the Mules bullpen. That wind, which is again blowing toward the left field foul pole, just simply blew it out of play. So it's now a full count, 3-2 to Ryan Hunter. Ben Kelsch has 8 strikeouts today. He has allowed a half a dozen hits. Senior right-hander kicks and delivers, and he's just issued his first walk, just missing inside. So Ryan Hunter is the first Lion to walk today.
Second baseman, number one.
And they put their leadoff man on here in the ninth for Dexter Swims. Swims 1-for-3. Reached on an infield single back in the fourth when the Lions put together their best inning offensively with a homer and two singles. Swims rolls this one toward third. Snurbush grabs to second for the force play to first, double play. Ah, dandy, 5-4-3, twin killing for the Mules defense to turn over their 51st double play of the year. That was not an easy play by Snurbush, but he turned it into a jam.
I think what makes that play go is he drop-stepped into the six hole between him and the shortstop, fielded it, made sure of the first one, and then sinks with a fantastic turn. Ball in and out of his glove, good strong throw to Taylor for the second out.
So now the Mules down to one out. Denver Coffey at the plate takes the first pitch outside for a ball.
Pinch hitter for the Lions, number 15, Garen Stevens.
Take that back. Obviously a pinch hitter. Garen Stevens, senior from Ontario, Canada. Batting for the first time in this ball game. Right-handed batter takes a pitch low 2-0. All the Wells Country Meats at the northeast corner of the junction of Highways 50 and 13. Proud UCM Athletic supporter. Phone number 747-8261. 2-0 pitch to Stevens. hit in the air on the right side. Sinks, charging, or coming to his right, makes the catch, just in fair territory. And the Mules take game one in this sub-regional. And Ben Kelsch, 117 pitchers. Mules win it by a final score of 8-1. Mules win for the 39th time this year. And they will play at noon tomorrow in a winner's bracket contest here at the Division II Central Sub-Regional.